Welcome to another Realvolve training video. In this segment, we're going to cover how to take an email that comes in from maybe a lead generation website and import it into Realvolve. Here I have just a sample email. It's got a person's name, email, phone number, and a desired price range as a comment. What we want to do is take this information and we want to import it right into Realvolve. The way we do that is we use Zapier that allows third parties to be able to bring in information, and they have a special parser that allows you to import stuff. So you can go to parser.zapier.com. Once you create a mail parser account, and it will give you a section here for mailboxes. What we want to do is we want to create a mailbox. Now it will start the process of creating a mailbox and give you 8 seconds to choose one that you want. In this case, it's just a temporary email address. It refreshes every 8 seconds. And if you don't pick one, it'll go to the next one. All you have to do is click on the skip waiting. What that does is that creates that email address for you with an @robot.zapier.com. And it's prefixed with some sort of arbitrary letters and numbers. Really don't have to worry about that too much. Basically, what we want to do is just click on the save address and template so that it creates this address for you. We want to copy this address and go to whatever application that sends this email to you. What you want to do is you want to add this Zapier email address, the parser.zapier.com address, to whatever it is that's sending you this normal email. So now that I have the email set up in my WooFoo forms, in this case, I just went and took the parser email address that I had created for the mailbox, and I had put it into my WooFoo form. In it, whenever a form is filled out, it will automatically send it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just put in some basic information and then click on the submit button. The information from that form then gets sent to my normal email address, and it also gets sent to the parser mailboxes. So what we're going to do is we're going to come over back over to parser, and we're just going to refresh this screen. You'll then see that a new email has come in 0 minutes ago. It just came in. So I'm going to click on this 0 minutes ago, and it will show me that we do not have a template for it yet. It's an email that came in at 12:06 p.m. on March 20th. What I want to do is I want to create a new template. So I'm going to come over here to the template section and click on template. It'll then tell me that I need to create the template. In this case, I'm going to click on the click here. And it goes ahead and shows me the form in the template editor. Each of the fields that are in this that you want to retain in the Realvolve database, we want to create fields. And these fields can name them virtually anything you want. So in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and highlight this as being the full name. So I'm going to highlight Joe Young and type in full name. And that gives that particular field a name. I'm going to click on and highlight the email address and just type in email. Do the same thing for phone number. And in this case, I'm going to highlight a given area. I'm just going to put this in as a note. So what I've done is I've identified all the different fields that are part of this email. By doing that, I can now save this. I'm going to scroll down here and click on Save the Address and Template. Now, if I go and look at this now, it'll say that it was done 2 minutes ago. It highlights the fields, and you can see as you move over it, it gives you the field name as a little pop-up. And whenever I click on the output, that gives me the individual fields, just showing you exactly what they are. I've got the email field, the note field, the full name field, and the phone number. We want to take these fields and the fields that are in this email and actually put them through the Zap. We want to go over to Zapier.com and make sure that you log in. If you don't have a Zapier account, go ahead and create an account. It's free. There are paid versions of this, so that if you need more access, you can certainly do that. For most cases, you can just use the free one. And then once you've got an account set up, then you can log in. Now, once you are logged into Zapier, it'll take you to your dashboard. If you're not at your dashboard, click on the dashboard at the top, and it'll bring you to your dashboard. And this is where it allows you to create your own Zaps. I want to click on the button that says Make a New Zap. From here, we need to choose a trigger app. A trigger app is what app is it that starts the actual process of merging the information. In this case, we want to use the mail parser. So we can come over to email parser, and it will then allow us to start putting in information about the parser. We want to trigger it based off of a new email coming into that mailbox from parser.zapier.com. So I'm going to click on new email and click on save and continue. Now, it's going to want to know which mailbox am I using. In this case, I've got some that are previously set up. You won't have those in there. What you want to do is click on connect a new account. It will then go through the process of asking you to authorize your new parser.zapier account. So click on authorize. And then at that point, it will go ahead and put it in as an account for you. So here we have the Zapier email parser account number one. I'm going to click on test just to make sure. And sure enough, it says that we've succeeded. At this point, I'm going to click on the save and continue. We've got our account that we want to use. And it starts taking you through these different steps over here. So the question becomes, what is the mailbox that we want to use from that account? I'm going to click on the little down arrow, and there is the email address that we had just set up. I'm going to click on continue. And now it's going to let me fetch and continue some of the emails that are in there and allow us to start communicating with it. So I'm going to click on fetch and continue. And it says that it's successful. Great. We're just going to click on continue. It now wants to know, what is the action app? The action app is, what application are we going to bring these emails into? In this particular case, we're going to bring them into Realvolve. So you can just type in Realvolve, and we're going to choose the Realvolve app. The action itself is to create a contact. So I'm going to click on save and continue on. It's going to ask me, which account do I want to use for this? What we've got to do is we've got to create a new account. And just ignore the ones that I've got there, because I've used this for several things. But I want you in your account to click on connect a new account. At this point, it's going to ask you for a Realvolve API key. Now, the Realvolve API key is a key that lets Zapier communicate with Realvolve. You want to log into your Realvolve account. And I'm going to click on the little arrow down for settings. We'll choose settings. And on the left-hand side, we have an integrations menu item. Click on integrations, and this will show you the Zapier API key. You can come over here and just click on the little copy button to copy that address into your clipboard. Once you have that API key in your clipboard, come back to your API key account in Zapier, and let's paste that in there. So I'm going to right-click and paste. And it puts that in there. You'll see it's grayed out. It's not something you want to share, but it is there. And we'll say yes and continue. At this point now, it has created the Realvolve account and just says, you know, added 0 minutes ago. So we know it's there. We can click on test to make sure it succeeds. And then once it succeeds, we're good to go. We're going to click on save and continue. Now that we know which account to put the emails into, we want to know which fields you want to use. You can click into the field itself and type in information. The better option is actually to use the insert field, which shows you a drop-down list of all the fields that are available. Click on that again. Created a field called full name. So if I come down here, you'll see that it says parse output full name. I want to go ahead and click on full name. And what that does is that puts in that field into the full name field. The other fields that I had was for the phone number. So I'm going to come down here to the mobile number field in Realvolve. And we want to put in the parse output phone number. And likewise for the email, this was parse output email. And if we go all the way down to the bottom, I'll go over a couple of these other ones. There was one field here for notes. And what you can do with notes is pretty cool. You can put in a prefix for things. So if I wanted to say we're going to put in the price range, put in price range just as normal text. And then I want to also put in whatever I had put into the note field. I just called it note, but it could have been called price range, in which case I put it there. So it will put in the text words price range and then whatever's in that price range field. And I can put other fields in there as well if I want to prefix it with something, but it's all going to go into that note field so that I can see it from one place. To show you a couple other fields that are important as you're going through here, there's a section here for tags. And then whenever this lead comes in, you may want it to start a workflow. If you've got a new lead workflow, we could click on the little down arrow on this. This is going to be any kind of contact workflow. So I'm going to go ahead and just choose the Digs Buyer Lead Kit. Once you have everything the way you want, just click on the continue button. And this will show you kind of a sample of what information is going to be brought in to Realvolve. We'll click on create and continue. Click on finish and then give this zap a name. I'm just going to call it new lead and I'm going to turn this zap on. I'm going to then go back to my dashboard. And now you'll see that I've got my new lead zap in here. If I ever need to edit it, I can just click on this, make any kind of changes as need be, and then save it as well. So now I have my zap created. At this point, anytime anybody fills out a new form, and that form gets emailed to me through the parser.zapier.com account, it then automatically comes into Zapier. You'll see that there's an instant option here. So it instantly comes right into Realvolve at that point. So very easy to set up. It just takes a little bit of setup process. Once it is set up, you're good to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my form. In this case, I was just using a WooFoo form and I'm going to fill in the information again. Once I have everything filled out, I'm going to click on submit. This is where it takes the information that's in here and automatically sends it as an email to my parser.zapier.com account. Zapier then forwards it into Realvolve. I can click on my contact screen and immediately you'll see the name is in there. If I click on Sue Seller, I'll see the information, the name, the phone number, the email that I put in. And you'll also see in this case, it created the note. The note has the little label that I put on it and the selected price range that we had entered. Also, the tags that were created are in that contact record. Whenever I go to the activities, you'll see that it has already created my workflow and that is all in place. If these things are set up to go automatically, you'll immediately get those emails going out, those text messages going out. You really don't have to do anything for it to do the process automatically. So you are all set. Very easy. It does take a little bit of setup for the parser screens to be able to parse that information, but once you get it set up once, you're all good to go. So I hope that helps you. If you have any questions, visit our website, visit our help site, or just send us an email. We'll be happy to answer whatever questions you have. I hope you have a great day.